Hello everyone, welcome to our channel Reese52 that is all about DIY electronics projects with Arduino, Raspberry Pi, ESP8266 and other popular boards. In today's tutorial, we will use ESP32 board to wirelessly operate a 12-volt fan over the Blink application in an Android smartphone. So the required components are here. So we will need a breadboard, a 12-volt 0.065 ampere printer cooling fan, and the 5-volt 1-channel relay board. So it's an electrically operated switch. So relays are used where it is necessary to control a circuit by a separate low power signal or where several circuits must be controlled by one signal. So it's an automatic switch to controlling a high current circuit with a low current signal. So now some male to female jumper wires, and the main component is ESP32 expressive room learning board with USB cable. So this ESP32 room 32 is a powerful generic Wi-Fi Bluetooth MCU module. The integration of Bluetooth LE and the Wi-Fi ensures that a wide range of applications can be targeted, and the module is future proof. Using Wi-Fi allows a large physical range and direct connection to the internet through a Wi-Fi router, while using Bluetooth allows the user to conveniently use the phone or broadcast low energy beacons for its directions. So it has 18 analog to digital converter channel with 10 capacitive sensing GPIOs, 3 UART interface, 3 SPI and 2 I2C interface. You can check the more details here. And in the last, a 12 volt 1 ampere DC adapter. So all the components are available on our website reese52.com and the link given in the description. So let's start making the circuit. And here is the circuit diagram. So first of all, attach the ESP32 Wi-Fi module with the breadboard. So now connect 5-volt 1-channel relay with the ESP32 board. So connect the signal pin of 5-volt relay module with the D4 pin of ESP32. Then connect the VCC pin of 5-volt 1-channel relay module with the 3.3-volt pin of ESP32. Connect the ground pin of 5-volt 1-channel module with the ground pin of ESP32. So now we will connect the DC adapter with the relay module. So connect the positive wire of 12-volt DC adapter with the COM port of relay module. So now connect the cooling fan with the 5-volt 1-channel relay module. So connect the red wire of cooling fan with the NO port, that is the normally open port, with the relay module. Then connect the negative wire of 12-volt DC adapter with the negative wire of cooling fan. So as you can see, all the connections are completed. So now we will set up for the board installation. So let's see. So what you need to do, first of all, install the current upstream Arduino IDE. You can download it according to your operating system and the link given in the description. So open the Arduino software. Now we need to install the ESP32 board we have already installed in our system. If you want to learn how to install ESP32 board, you can refer our link in description or go to the info button. So after installing the ESP32 board, now plug the cable to the ESP32 to select the VMOS Lolin 32 board to Arduino IDE. Go to Tools, then select the board. that is VMOS Lawlin 32. And also select the COM port that is available other than COM1. So this is how you can install the appropriate boot. After that, we will set up the Blink application. So the link for Blink application is given in the description. So after downloading, it will look like this. Now open the app. Now register your account if you are new here. We have already created the account, so we'll create a new project. So to create a new project, click to the new project. Then you can enter your project name here. Now select the board, which is ESP32 development board. Then click OK. Then click to the create button. You will get an authentication token on your registered email ID. So copy the authentication token and paste in the code right here. Must enter your SSID and the password of the Wi-Fi that must be entered correctly in the phone connected with. Now back to the app, then click the plus icon to add the button widget right here. Now then set up to this button. So click it. Now select the input pin, that is the GP4 pin as digital pin. Now go back. So your app is ready to use. Now go back to the upload section and click to the upload button. Let's wait until the uploading is finished. So as you can see, the code is completely uploaded. Now press the play button. So as you can see, the device is already connected to the board. You can check the status whether it is offline or online. So press the button. Then you can see the fan is rotating. Now again leave the button, then fan will turn off. So this on-off switch controls the motion of fan directly by Blink application, which accesses the Wi-Fi SSID point created by ESP32. So I hope this video will be helpful for you. Subscribe our channel to get more video updates. Thank you.